In this radio show and podcast, we talk about fruit trees. We talk about how to grow them and how to care for them, but we rarely talk about how to make a fruit tree from scratch. Now, you may think I'm nuts for even mentioning it. After all, you can just plant a seed from your favorite apple and you'll get an apple tree. Johnny Appleseed did it. He planted thousands of apple trees in Pennsylvania and Ohio in the 1800s, but the resulting fruit might not have tasted very good. Now, that didn't matter at the time because apples then were mostly used for animal feed or for making cider. You see, the problem is that apples and many other different types of fruit, they don't grow true to seed. So, for example, each seed in a delicious Honeycrisp apple will produce a genetically unique tree with genetically unique fruit. So, if you want to grow Honeycrisp apples or any other specific variety of fruit, you need to plant a grafted or a cloned tree. We're going to learn how to do that in the show today with my guest, Steph Roth of Silver Creek Nursery in Ontario. Steph, thank you so much for coming on the show today.
Oh, thanks very much for inviting me.
I want to talk to you a little bit about your history. Like, did you graft fruit trees from when you were just like a little girl, or is this a relatively newer thing for you?
It's a little newer. I'd say probably about 5 years ago would have been when I first started grafting. And that was working for my cousin Ken, who was the previous owner of Silver Creek Nursery. But a couple of years ago, I had bought it over. So
was it easy for you right away? Is no. Grafting a new fruit tree like a super easy thing for a brand new person approaching it?
It's practice. If you practice a lot, then you'll have better success for sure.
A grafted tree is made up of two pieces. One of the pieces is called a rootstock. Can you tell me what is a rootstock and what does it contribute to the final tree?
It's the root part of the tree, and it's typically like 4 to 6 inches above ground is where your graft union, and that's the site at which you would graft the two pieces together. So your rootstock consists of a bit of trunk and then all the roots below.
So that's part one. So now you take part two. Part two is the scion. So tell me, what is the scion and how is that different?
So the scion, it's 1 year growth. So the tip end of a branch, but the scion is going to be the variety that you want the tree to grow into and produce fruit. For example, Honeycrisp or Gala or whatnot.
You mentioned whip and tongue grafting, a very scary name for something that actually, when you think about it, it's kind of simple. So how do you describe what whip and tongue grafting is? What are you trying to do?
Essentially, what you're trying to do is cut the material to expose the inner layers of the tree, the inner, there's the bark and then the cambium is inside the bark. And then you have the woody tissue inside that, and then the pith in the very center. So you want to make a diagonal cut across the pieces of material, the rootstock and the scion. And that cut will expose those surfaces. The cambium produces cells that will divide and form callus tissue, which will then heal the two cut surfaces together to become one tree, basically.
So basically, you're going to have two pieces of tree. You've got your rootstock, you've got your scion wood, and they have to have a matching cut that you need to learn in order to do that. What tools do you need in order to do that jigsaw cut?
Ideally, a single bevel knife is preferred, but it's not mandatory. The most important thing is to have a very, very, very sharp knife. Say you get a brand new knife, still sharpen it and just get it like razor sharp. And then you're going to find your cuts are much, much easier to do. They'll be much smoother. You'll be able to move through the wood better and you'll have a better chance of success. So really having a sharp blade is key.
Okay. So you've got your two pieces. They fit together perfectly because of course you've done your perfect cut. They'll fall apart. Like how do you stick these pieces together so that they stay until they kind of grow together to become one tree, to fuse into one tree?
You can use anything as basic as an elastic, but cut it so that it's just one string, basically. And then you can use that to bind, twist around the cut site, the graft union, and hold them together. Then you would apply a grafting wax, which would seal the nooks and crannies, basically. And that would be an option that way. However, what we've moved to is using buddy tape. So it's a biodegradable, very, very stretchy, picture saran wrap or something like that, but much, much stretchier than saran wrap. And you wrap that around the tree. And the brand that we use is biodegradable. So it does just come off after about a year, which is great.
Well, how long is the ideal length of that piece of scion? How long should it be? Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Ideally, ultimately, you want, you know, between 1 and 3 buds. If you have more than 3 buds, that's not a good thing either, though. So you don't want your scion to be too long. The reason being, that little chunk of wood has a certain amount of energy in it. And if you have a really long scion wood, all those buds are going to be pushing and using up that energy really fast in spring. And you can actually end up having the top part of your tree sort of expend all that energy and dry up, sort of thing, just because it doesn't have enough energy quick enough to support all those excessive buds. So that's why you want to kind of keep it topped up at no more than 3 buds, generally our rule of thumb.
The 1 or 2 buds left get the energy that's there. And I find that really fascinating, that a little tiny little piece of branch from a tree that produces yummy fruit will eventually grow into this huge trunk for a full-size tree that will feed you and your family for generations to come. That's amazing. Isn't that amazing? Or is this just me?
Definitely. Oh, no, I think it's fantastic. I think, yeah, it is. It's crazy. It totally is.